So again, beginning by meeting your inner world. And starting by grounding yourself in the body. Remembering the two aspects of kindfulness. Mindfulness, which is like the light of the sun. And kindness, which is like the warmth of the sun. These two are always inseparable. So as your mindfulness flows through the body, it becomes a medium through which your kindness can also reach every single part, every sensation, every feeling, mood and emotion. Illuminating and warming every experience. Just as the sun shines impartially on everything it contacts. So allowing that kindfulness to permeate the whole body-mind phenomena, leaving no part untouched. Soothing, calming every experience down. And this time when we evoke the presence of the loved person, or any other object that you've chosen to develop loving kindness towards. We're going to picture them sitting at a table, a large round table, maybe made of oak or another beautiful wood. In a very cozy room, maybe with a fireplace, perhaps candles burning. Maybe food and drinks on the table, non-alcoholic, of course. Perhaps the smell of freshly baked bread or cake. A very warm and inviting place, a safe place. And you're sitting there with your friend, partner, child, parent, or your little plant or your little kitten. Enjoying each other's company. Without needing to say very much, but just drinking in that person's presence and connecting with your heart's deepest aspiration for that person's well-being. Remaining connected to your own heart and connected to the other person. Gently repeating the words of loving kindness, calmly, clearly, repeatedly, offering the most beautiful of your intentions to this other person in your life. And remaining connected to your own heart, noticing in the space between the phrases where that metta is pointing to the emotional feeling of loving kindness, and giving that feeling time and space to develop at its own speed. And as your metta flows from your heart towards the loved person, it brings a smile to their face and fills the room with a beautiful, warm, golden glow of loving kindness. and really connecting with the meaning of your intentions. Not allowing them to become automatic. And listening in the spaces. Allowing the seeds to take root and to flourish. Remaining connected to the feeling in your own body and your intentions of metta, and keeping that friend in mind. If you wish, you may invite other people into the room. Maybe other friends, or perhaps someone you don't know very well. Whoever wishes to enter, see if you can include them in the field of loving kindness, understanding that you can ask them to leave at any time. And just allowing whoever wishes to come in to come. And if no one else comes to mind, just staying with your friend or the loved person. If you find yourself in company, you may change the phrase to "May we be happy." May we be peaceful, etc. And as your metta fills the room, everyone there relaxes, enjoying each other's silent company, enjoying the warmth of the fire. We're coming towards the end of the meditation. So staying connected to your own body and to any feelings that have arisen related to loving kindness. Just gently invite your guests to leave, thanking them for their presence, bidding them farewell. And bring all your loving awareness back into your own body. Extending the well wishes towards yourself. Allowing the words to fade away, just remaining in the presence of loving awareness. Noticing any feelings of peace, quiet, happiness in the mind. And just lingering in those feelings.